Alright, now we're going to go through setting up a virtual machine on your Windows computer. So, first thing to do is you'll need to download the CSE virtual machine. And the CSE SOC virtual machine is Xubuntu, and you'll find it at this link here. The link will also be provided along with this video. So the one we want to get is the one that has VMDK in it. So that's this one here. Now that's a fairly big download. That's about 4 gigabytes. So you might want to do it while you're at university. All right. Luckily I already have that downloaded. So we need to get the next piece of software, which is VirtualBox. So if you just Google for VirtualBox, now the first link here, virtualbox.org, will allow us to download VirtualBox. All right, so let's choose Downloads. And then we want to choose Windows. And it will download here. All right, so that's downloaded. And then we can click that to install. All right, we'll run that. All right, you can leave these as on their default options. And we can choose yes. Let's make a shortcut on the desktop. Alright, each time one of these pops up, we want to install. Now we're done. So let's start VirtualBox. Alright, so there's one more thing you'll need, and that is 7-zip to extract the disk image that you downloaded. So if you Google 7-zip, the first link here should get it. Download 7-zip, and you can choose the 32-bit or the 64-bit based on your operating system. And remember to check that, you can just find your computer, right-click, and go Properties. And under System Type, it will show you which type of operating system it is. So this one is 64-bit, so we'll download the 64-bit version. And you can use that to extract the disk image that you downloaded here. So now I'll go to that disk image, which is in my downloads folder, and it's this one here. I've already extracted it. So in a VirtualBox, we'll open that up and we'll choose new, the new button here. And we can call it whatever we want, but I'm going to put CSE X Ubuntu 2017. Any name is fine. And we want to choose Linux and Ubuntu 64-bit. We might have to choose this from the drop-down, but make sure it's Ubuntu 64-bit. Alright, if you don't see the 64-bit option, you may have to enable Hypervisor in your BIOS. And so the best thing to do there is to Google how to do that for your computer. Now that we've chosen that, we can choose Next and set the memory size. We can set the memory size to be, let's say 2 gigabytes. 2 gigabytes is reasonable. So we can even put 2048, which is a power of 2. All right. And here, we want to choose use an existing virtual hard disk. And then we want to go over to this folder icon right here, so we can select the file that we downloaded. So if we go to our downloads folder, and this one right here, and we can open that. and then we can go create. All right, so that has all the details there. And to start our machine, we can just hit start. We can close these little notifications here. So you should see a login window here. So for CSC XUbuntu 2017, the password is change me. So change in lowercase and then me in uppercase, capital M, capital E. All right, then we can choose login. And it will ask us to enter the username which we use to log in to our account at the School of Computer Science. So the CSC username will be your ZID. And then we can go update config files. All right, and now we'll have a virtual machine that looks just like our lab machine. We can choose to open a terminal or to SSH into a CSC terminal remotely. And this means we can edit text with any text editor, like Gedit, just as we would on the lab machine. And when we're ready to copy our files up to CSC, we can use SCP. Put now the Zpass in here, so all right, and we will be connected to CSC. All right. Feel free to update the software if you would like to. And there's one last thing we can do with the virtual machine that will be quite useful. And that is if you want to move files from your Windows computer to your virtual machine. And I'll show you how to do that. We want to go up here to Devices. And we want to choose Shared Folders and Shared Folder Settings. Now when this opens up, we want to click the plus button here to add, and then under folder path, we can browse to a folder we want to mount. So I'm going to select a new folder here, comp1511. There we go. And then select this folder. There we go. And then we want to check auto mount and make permanent. And that way, any files that are in this folder will also appear, will also be available to us in our Linux virtual machine. Okay, once we've done that, the last step is to restart the computer. So let's go up here and choose the logout option, and then we can choose restart. All right, so now if we go to file system, we will see there is sfcomp1511 here, and that anything in here will appear on our Windows folder and our Windows machine. All right, so if I create a folder lab01 here, and then on Windows, I check that. So computer. There we go, and that folder is there as well. The last thing you want to do is make sure that you can copy and paste to and from your Windows computer and the virtual machine. So under Devices, you want to go to Shared Clipboard, and then you want to choose Bidirectional. And if you want to be able to drag and drop files in and out of your virtual machine, you can also choose Drag and Drop Bidirectional. All right, so that's it for running a virtual machine on your Windows computer.